say Azania, referring to this, and I know it can be very controversial, because the name Azania is associated with the Pan-Africanist Congress of Azania. It is also associated with the Azanian People's Movement. And it does get worse, because in my younger days, when I was very radical, I was a leader in the Black Consciousness Movement of Azania. So you can just imagine, if I'm now associating with Apostle Linda and she says Azania and it's not explained, I say, we said this man is in a political game, it's coming out, it's coming out. Let me explain. On the 2nd of October this year, a prayer warrior from Uganda, Canon Christine Shimanya, sent a word which I will urge Apostle Mogoeng to circulate. She says, the Lord says, those of us, we pray. When we pray, we mustn't refer to this country as South Africa, because it is that name that enables division, hatred, suspicion, oppression, and that opposes the move of God. He says we must call it Azania. I was shocked. Say, hey, that sounds political. So I said, let me check, what is the meaning of this Azania? To my shock, Azania means God hears. So the Lord says, if anybody wants to punish me for saying the Lord says, that's their problem. I'm happy to be punished for that. The Lord says, this country is Azania. So when we pray, we must pray not for South Africa, but for Azania. But you must get a revelation. Ask him, did he say it? So that you can pray and tell others with confidence. Don't take it from me. Don't take it from Apostle Linda. Don't take it from our sister Christine Shimanya. Ask the Lord. He'll confirm it, just as he confirmed it to us. Now, the first thing we must do is to thank God. May we please rise, those of us who can. Let's thank God for bringing us together today in this city and in this province of the first.